The last method you can add photo to MySQL is to add it exactly to MySQL. So how will we do that? Here we make this to add a photo directly to the database. What do you think it will happen when we upload the file here? Let's test it. What I call it, photo DB. Yeah. Let's make a post request to photo DB with a request and a response. The image is request.body.image product image, and they have the name and the price too. Let's console log the image. And the name. And let's see what happened. If we go to add photo, we add a photo like test price 1111, and they added a file here, pen. So add the product with photo. Let's see what happened. We have the pen name and the name of the product, but we don't have the photo. But we don't have the photo, we only have the name. So what else we can do? First thing we need to do is change the encoding type. We need to set the encoding type to be multi-platform. So we just type encoding type multi-platform form data, because by default it is application x www form URL encoded. This is the default encoding type you will get. We will change it to this, and let's test this now. What will we get? I have test, let's test 1 1 and add the product. As you can see, we get undefined. So what we can do to fix it, we need to implement a package called malter. Let's search it. Malter. Yeah, which is a node middleware for handling multi-part form data, which is primarily used for uploading files. Exactly what we need. So let's install it. npm install malter and save. Now we need to require it. Go here, malter. And we need to make a variable. Let's call it upload. We set it to be malter, and an object storage malter.memory storage. Yeah, so we will use this so we can upload a specific file to our server. If we go back to our post request here, we need to give it as a parameter, and let's say upload dot single, and we need the image name, which is product image. Yeah, now we can access the image by simply typing image equal to reg.file, because we only have one file and the file have the name of product image, which is the input here. And let's console log the image. Let's try to get it from the body to see what happened. Image v2 request.body.product image. Let's run and see what happened. Test 1 1, let's write it again, the pen, and add the product with photo. As you can see, we get a field name, product image, original name, which is pen, and you have it here, the encoding and the buffer. This is the size of the pen and the pen stored in the buffer here in bytes. So what we need to do now is to encode the buffer into a string. So let's say, oh yeah, and we don't have only the name and the image is undefined. You can find it, the image, if we request it with the body. So from the file we need a buffer, and let's convert it to string in base 64, oh my god. Yeah, I'm console log it again. Let's see what happened now. Test, let's refresh it, 1 1 1 1, and add the product. Now we get a long string of characters, and this is our photo. Let's save it to the database. Insert into product v2 values null, the name of the product, the price. We don't have an image path, so we set it here as null, and then we need a question mark here because we have the image here in the database. Yeah. Let's make the connection. We have the name, the price, and the image. Let's redirect the products again. Now nothing will happen because we didn't make the else statement here. So let's make it else and we need to close this as well. Make a li. Let's copy this. Now we need to say that the photo is embedded image, and for the source we need the image here, not the path. Also we need to add that the photo is in base 64, so we add that by typing, oh my god, here. We need to type data image PNG and base 64. Let's check it again. Data image PNG base 64. Yeah, it should work now. I closed everything and we should be good to go. Let's test this. Add the product, candidate property buffer of undefined. Let's see what happened. Images reg.file buffer to string base 64. What buffer? I forgot to close it here. So this was the problem. Let's check it now. It should work. Let's see. Test DB price 999, add the product, and we have the pen finally. Let's check the database, make the query, and here it is. Let's copy it. Yeah, and this is our photo. So that's it. This is how you can import photos to MySQL. You can put it in local file and give it a path. You can get it from the web browser, or you can store the whole photo, but you need to save it in a string. And the string is pretty big. Okay, this was the tutorial. Thank you for the view and see you in the next video. Bye.